cancer. Doesn't the term scare us all? Well, it surely does. But how does this bizarre disorder grip our lives? How is it able to conquer over our mind, body, and soul? Why is it so crazy? Let's find the answers in this video. We will start by understanding what exactly cancer is. We all know that the cells in our body continuously divide. Cell division occurs for various reasons, ranging from growth and development to repair. However, the process happens in an orderly manner. Now, if the cells lose control over their division process, then the uncontrolled division can lead to the formation of lumps of outrageous cells. This is nothing but cancer. In simple words, cancer is a disorder which develops when the cells in our body grow out of control, creating a cell mass. This mass of cells is known as tumour. Now tell me, is every tumour growing in the body always cancerous? Many of us would say yes. The answer is no. Every tumour is not cancerous. A tumour is a mass or lump of cells. So depending upon whether it's capable of invading other tissues and cause harm, or it can silently remain at one place without harming other cells in the vicinity, a tumour is classified into two major types. One type is called malignant and the other type is called benign. Let's understand each type individually. Sometimes, a few cells lose their ability of controlled division and form a tumour. But after a particular time, the tumour does not grow much in size and remains calm at its place. It does not spread across the blood to invade surrounding tissues. These calm, harmless, and non-cancerous tumours are called benign tumours. On the other hand, malignant tumours are cancerous. They spread and invade other body tissues. Here, their aggressive nature helps the tumour cells to derive nutrients from other surrounding healthy cells. As a result, the healthy cells die, and this gives the tumour cells an opportunity to grow even faster. The process of spreading of the cancer cells to the other body parts and then growing continuously in these locations is known as metastasis. Now that we've learned about the types of tumours, let's move ahead and learn about the types of cancer. Are there types of cancers? Yes, there are. Among the several types of cancer studied today, we will mainly focus on the three major types. On our list, we have carcinomas, sarcomas, leukemias, and lymphomas. Let's have a look at these types. Carcinomas are cancers of the epithelial tissues. That means carcinomas are developed in the skin and tissue lining of the organs like prostate, breast, colon, pancreas, lungs, and so on. The next type is that of sarcomas. These types arise in the connective tissues like bone cells, cartilage, muscles, and other soft tissues in the body. Now, talking about lymphomas and leukemias, aren't the names self-explanatory? Lymphomas, as the name suggests, are the cancers that develop in the lymphocytes, which are a type of white blood cells. On the other hand, cancers which result in an abnormal amount of blood cells, like abnormal number of red blood cells or leukocytes, are known as leukemias. Leukemias and lymphomas are types of blood cancers. And how is any of these types detected? There are several techniques developed today, all thanks to the modern science and technology. For diagnosis, various tests are performed in the patients. Imaging techniques like X-ray, computer tomography, magnetic resonance imaging, PET CT scan, and many more are performed. These imaging techniques give the medical examiner an idea of the size, shape, and the location of a particular tumour or multiple tumours inside the body. Similarly, blood tests can be done to find out the different types of blood cancers. Biopsies of the tissues are also done for better diagnosis. That is, a small sample of tissue, or the tumour to be precise, is removed from the patient's body to determine the nature of cancer. Oncologists, that is the medical practitioners dealing with cancers, believe that early diagnosis of any type of cancer gives a better chance of curing the case, and this increases the survival rate in the cancer patients. The most common treatments for cancer include surgery, chemotherapy, and radiotherapy. Surgeries are performed to remove the tumor from the body. In chemotherapy, various drugs which inhibit the growth of growing cells in the body are used. Since these drugs kill the growing cells, all the aggressively growing cancer cells get killed with different doses. Lastly, radiotherapy focuses on destroying tumor cells using different radiations. High doses of radiation are used to kill or shrink tumor cells. Apart from these, there are various other techniques which are being developed and are under trial stages in clinical testing. A healthy lifestyle and avoiding exposure to harmful chemicals and radiation are a few steps to keep our body cells from getting damaged and turn aggressive. Also, regular health checkups, which can help in early detection of any type of tumor, can increase the chances of curing the patient. This was about one of the most dangerous disorders that the human race is fighting today. To know more about these interesting concepts, do subscribe to our channel. Happy learning!